Hey everyone, it's the Expander. Welcome back to Seopolis 2, where coming close to the end game, to be honest. I've had to switch this off because it's full and it will burn through all my Insanium. So, I have made a ore producer using the cognizant ore. So, in a tank hooked up to my lava generators. All the blocks to turn this. Four seems to be the best one to work with. Four of these with one of those and one clicker with six sieves seems to be an optimum setup. But yeah, four this produce all the way down into here. Goes to click, that gets sieved. I've put them all into drawers so they don't fill out my storage. But yeah, look at that. I put some emerald upgrades in some, not in others. But that, I really need to put one in glowstone, to be honest. But yeah, 65,000 emeralds, diamonds, nether scrap, redstone, the important creative organic spores that we need. Hook it up to a draw controller, stick void upgrades on them all. Yeah, that is a fantastic little thing. Also, 65,000 echo shards, so making more dimensional shards is going to be a lot easier. This does the glowstone, doesn't it? Yeah, it does. I should have put a glowstone on them. Oh well, I've got glowstone essence. Not like I want to run short of this stuff. Move my creatives up here. So we've got plenty of creative essence now. Or at least for now. Started running out of drawers, so I had to put a couple here, which included the graphite and the dye seeds. Because it would annoy me the fact that I couldn't make any of the dye that I wanted to. I didn't put any upgrades on that either. Oh well, it'll be right. I don't need a lot of dye. And then clean up in here. So we've just got the lava generators in here. We don't need the power generators because we've got this monster, which has only produced 53 cyanide. Because, I mean, look how slowly it actually goes down. So, this has got 2,000 uranium ingots. This has got full stack and full things. The drawers have got thousands of essence. Yeah, we do not need any more of that for a while. The mob. I switched the mob farm back to the slot factory just so I've got the meat, which I've got a metric ton of now, so my meat feeder's doing well. I made myself a flux magnet and then realised because I've got a load of the magnet thing, especially in there, I was picking up lots of ore drops, so I made it and then never switched it on. Yeah, got rid of a lot of the bulbs because we don't need fall protection because don't need double jump. Don't really need looting because I'm not exactly fighting out. Although we may go and fight a wither at some point because that'll make mince meat of it. It'd just be fun to do. I was on about building over here like an entire base of the whole factory process of producing the antimatter. But yeah. We're going to do it in there. But if we're going to do it in there, we're going to need refined storage access in there. So there's two ways we can do it. We can either upgrade that so that we can into a dimensional card, which means we can use it everywhere, any dimension, any time. But that only then means I can access my backpack. I can't access all of this automatically. So we are going to go for some wireless refined storage. So we need a couple of things. excuse me. We are going to need a network transmitter. a network receiver, and a network card. Upgrades, network card. Pressing random buttons Get me a couple more of them. Right, network card. I really should just make a bunch of these, but so there's the receiver. Like craft up these two, and there's the transmitter. So we got receiver. Right, I can never remember which way around this is. Yeah, so transmitter goes in here. We head over to our dungeon portal. Excuse me. And we can put our receiver here. We right-click or shift-click with this card, and that will take the block location of that transmitter. We go back into the portal. Put the card into there, and you'll see that changed dimension dungeon, dim dungeon build dimension. If I was to then get a... that's the best way of doing it, isn't it? I need one of those. You know, constantly run out of these, so I'm just gonna bloody build a bunch. Network card. I need three of those. Have I got... yeah. So just tell that to craft three of those. Oh, I only need two. Two of those. I'll be back when it's finished. And there's another rage booster. I also got to need another one of these. There we go. So now, when I pop into here, head up to my little gizmo here. That should be working. That's not working. Bugger. Okay. So it works. If I go to this receiver, right click. Good. Well, I shall. Let's take this one out. So, network card. Right click the receiver. Go down. Go to transmitter. Put it in. Go back up. We've got a connection. That works. But for some reason, doesn't work in the build dimension. Which is kind of imperative for it to work in the build dimension. Considering this is where we're going to be doing all the automation. The only other option I've got is compact machines. Yeah. For some reason, this dimension cannot receive the network signal. That is pigging annoying. Because that would have been a nice amount of space to get all the stuff you want to get. So... alright, he's going down, Swanny. We need compact machines. cut that in there as well while I'm at it. So, compact machines. We'd already got these and some of these as part of a bunch of quests we did. I mean, to be fair, compact machines is right up here. I mean, we could have done this bloody ages ago. But we need to know how to construct compact machine. So we need this set up somewhere to build as cubes with. So I'm going to do it up here. So if we put it there, we get ourselves some blocks. There we go. Brick. Let's go there. These need to be one taller. We're gonna do that just to make it go away again. And these need connecting like this. Now, compact machines have got a handy thing. So when you put one of these projectors down, pick that back up again. You right click with an empty hand and you get this holographic projection here. This basically tells you where to put the other projectors. So if I was to put one here and then right click with an empty hand again, it'll tell me the other ones need to go here and here. And we've got the projector box. The bigger the more space out the projectors are, the larger the compact machine you can make. So we need to make a tiny compact machine, which needs a block of copper and some walls. So we go a block of copper, and we need to build the machine. Block of copper in the middle, and then what you do is onto that entire block there we throw a rose ingot. So rose gold ingot, you just throw it on. That, there it is. We'll build a tiny compact machine, which we need in order to make our personal shrinking device, which allows us to go inside of a compact machine. Now, we could go inside, we could build another one to go inside. Oops, do that. However, as a reward for completing a quest, although I'll be damned if I remember which one. It's not going to let me do that. Is that one? Yeah. We got three compact machines. A giant, large, and a maximum. So you see, that is a 9x9 cube. So if we put the large down, right click with a shrinking device, we've got a 9x9 cube that we can do anything with. To leave again, just right click the outer wall. And when the game decides to put us back right outside it. The maximum is 13x13. It requires 26 walls, a rose gold ingot, and a block of netherite. So we can easily make plenty of maximum ones. Giant obsidian, largest diamond, or should I say large obsidian, giant diamond, maximum netherite. This separate there. Now, Compact Machines has got a couple of other things that are interesting. Item, fluid, and energy tunnels. So the way these work, if I go inside, and I say, oh, let's go for the east-facing wall, we'll put this little thing here. This lets us have an energy input into the cube. So if I go to there and go back outside, east facing walls, it's that one. So here, there's your room preview when you right click, but there's nothing in there at the minute. We could pump energy directly into the side of the cube. And it will get the energy needed through the air. Granted, we've got flux networks, so we don't really need any of that. So let me just go back inside. Take that back off. Oh. So if we didn't have this and flux or all this lot, we'd do that. But we do, so I can now go here. Get my receiver. Go into here. So we always spawn dead center, so I think what we'll do, we'll put the items against this wall. We link it with a network card. We'll leave. We hook that into there. We get our transmitter. Get our range booster. We don't even need the infinity one, we could get away with just the... Might have got to get away with just that. And it's not working cross-dimensionally. Why is this not working cross-dimensionally? I know why, they'll have disabled it. Damn it! Damn it. Right. Which means that is still a viable option. The other problem is I have to set up all my farms in there because I can't transfer things dimensionally. Or can I? Right, Mechanism's got something that I do love. The entangled quantum, or the quantum entangled potter, quantum entangled potter, this thing. Right, so quantum entangled potter requires a teleportation cube. Actually, I need two of these. Boop. Right. So flux set works. I transfer power there. I've got a flux. Can I leave it over there? Don't know now. Right. Let's just make another one. Right, so I can make a flux plug. We've got flux, that's fine. We've got energy. Oh, it's there. When it comes to the items, now, if we're making... we need antimatter, so we're going to need these machines. And the substrate is made from water, hydrogen, and biofuel. So we are going to need some plant life over there to crush. Right. So some stuff I can do with that, some stuff I can do with this. I need a draw. Throw my key in here, and there it is. Right. And I need make an antimatter for the antimatter. We need that. We need that. We need that. We need creative waste, which we get from creative organic matter, which we get from this. So I put that into the. I've got some of this. So I need to export creative essence and creative organic spores. Do these get used for anything else? Enchanted apples, which I need for the best hopper pots. Fair enough. Just for that. And the creative essence is made with the with that, which I've got an autocraft, yes. So I forgot what they're called. Oh bloody hell. Requester. And I do know that requesters, you don't need one per item. You can have multiple items in a requester. The reason I've kept it at one per item is because the last time I played with them, it had a major meltdown when you tried to put more than one item in the requester. And it was just not requesting items. It just didn't request anything, let alone the stuff that it needed to. Ooh, heads in way. So we're going to get that request. Always have four organic matter. Right. Here. We are going to. Set private network. Set creative. Tick. No, actually. Delete that. Delete. Creative. Organic. Whoops. Oh, stop being a pain in the ass. There we go. Creative organic. Creative organic. Right. So I've got creative organic. This. Just clear everything. Items. This is going to be input from the top. We are going to get an exporter. There. We are going to get some creative organic matter and export it to there. And that. I mean, you can see all the empty slots at the top and everything. But the main one is we've got air, gas, fluids, all sorts of stuff, and the organic matter. So it'll hold a stack of organic matter in there. Right. Did I get the flux point? Yeah, I did. So we can go back to trying to build it in here. Which is good because it gives me a lot more space to play with. So I can go. You set to that, and you'll see now it's picking up the organic matter that I'm outputting from there. Pair that with you there, and we can start this thing. So, what I need to do to create, I I'm going to create the machines. And then next episode, we're going to create the entire process. But I need to look at the HDP sheets. What are these going to be used for? Upgrades, plastics, which we don't really need, panels, the mech suit, which could be fun, but my current armor is just ridiculously powerful right now. So that, yeah, 8 armor, 3 toughness, 1 knockback. 12, 3.5, 1. So that's all good. We need the HDP sheets. Do we need them for? We need them for the SPS casing. So let's get this done now, because this is what we're going to need to start off with anyway. I can let this run for 5 minutes before we do the next one. We need a couple of dynamic, well, a couple of basic tanks, and pressurization chamber. We need a botany pot turned into an elite pot, turned into an ultra pot, turned into a ridiculous pot. Creative hopper botany pot. Right. In here, we need something that we can convert into biofuel. That's the stuff that we need. Not biofuel, substrate. That's what I need. Because substrate's then pressurized into HDP with liquid acetylene. Right, so I need biofuel, which is a crusher, and then mosque is 5 melon. For us, a 7 for baked potatoes, 5 for potatoes. 8 for cake, but we're not going to be making cake, so we're not cooking anything. So, warped blocks, pretty good. Yeah, I have a feeling we're just going to go for the humble potato. I'm going to see if it works, but just in case. If I can see if it works now, can I? Yes, it works. Right, so we've got the potato. We need a crusher. Couple of lava buckets. Need a couple of buckets. I do not need another pressurization chamber as well. Crusher. Which will just immediately turn into a factory. Can that be turned into a factory? I don't think it can it? No, but we are going to need another one anyway. Also, seeing as I can't send crafter over there, I need to make refined. So if I was to just add, right, craft that. I might, do you know what, given how long this has taken, I might just do quickly do this. Is it infinity range booster? Do you know what? I've crafted everything bar that. Seems like a waste because I'm only making two more of these, but let's get two more of these made. There's one. While that's doing that, let me go grab this one. So here's the thing, with the range booster, that was using 4,000 RF per tick. With the dimension card, which lets me use it anywhere and everywhere, we're now using 8,000 RF per tick. So yes, that's fine. Right. Right, let's get here. So this should have, yeah, it's got a stack of the creative in the right. But if I just for now get Crusher here, Botany Pot, Potato Farmland, you do input from the top, output to the right. Excellent. But now we've got the range booster. I could pull straight from the inventory there, so get you powered up. Excellent. And then you need to go into pressurized reaction chamber. So input, we'll make sure you've got auto eject on. That did not need to be a factory. But that's that there. Now we need to get hydrogen and water. Hydrogen comes from electrolyte separator and water. Yeah, definitely have to do this next episode. So we've got a factory anyway. I'm just gonna fucking highlight the entire thing. That is definitely more than enough space to build like everything that I've been making, but we'll chunk load those as well because these are going to be where the most of the stuff happens. And then I can just, I've got that set up so I can move that wherever I want it, and then we'll do another we can get another quantum entangle porter to send, or even an ender chest to send the HDP sheets back over here where I can use them to craft. So yeah, that'll be it for now. As always, if you like the episode, hit the like button. If you liked it, hit subscribe. Make sure you hit the notification bell so that it lets you know when new episodes come around, or just turn notifications on. It's not even a bell anymore, is it? Yeah, I'll be back. We'll get the HDP automator, we'll get the rest of the bits created so that we can start on antimatter and the antimatter cores. And to be perfectly honest, once we've hit this chapter, I am probably going to call it, because I'm not too fussed about the mountains of waiting around to get the final thing done. Or I might do, we never know. But also to say, you guys have a good one. Take care, city. I'll catch you in the next one. Bye-bye.